Hi, it's Dr. Liu here with Better Life Research Tips. I work with both graduate and undergraduate students, help them doing research and getting published. As a lifelong learner, I enjoy teaching. I believe teaching is a great way of learning because it's always forced me to learn more and forced me to clarify my source further and further. Writing literature review is a must-have and transferable skill for every researcher. Literature review is often a part of the introduction to a research paper or a thesis. But in fact, no matter whether or not there is a section called literature review in your paper, it is always one of the most important part of your research. Today, I want to talk about what is literature review, why we do it, and how do I start in order to conduct an effective literature review. I will start from a quote by Confucius. Confucius may be the greatest philosopher and educator in ancient China. He lived more than 2,000 years ago. He said, "Learning without thinking leads to confusion, while thinking without learning ends in danger." In Chinese, 学而不思则罔，思而不学则殆。If you are too ready to believe in anything you've learned, that may be called credulous. In fact, for each topic in your research, or each problem you try to solve, there may be tons of information available in literature. Without our own thinking, it is very easy to get misled or get drawn in the sea of information. On the contrary, thinking but without learning from others will make a person uninformed or even ignorant. Even if you are genius, you still do not want to waste your time to reinvent a wheel. This quote of Confucius is a perfect summary on why we do literature review, what we should include in our review. He pointed out the two key elements, learning and thinking. When we write our review, we want to demonstrate to our reader, we have learned, and we also have used our own thinking. In the learning part, it is very important that we include all major works in literature that are relevant to our specific topic. If we missed a relevant and well-known major work in our review is not professional. We should try our best to keep our reference up to date, including recent published works. Also, it is important to be objective. That means we should include not only the studies that agree with us, but also the studies that do not agree with us. Including a view from different sides will give us more credibility in our review. In the thinking part, first, we need to apply our critical thinking when we select information from literature to put into our review. It is important to keep an attitude of skepticism. Because all scientific findings are tentative and can be incorrect, we should treat all the results we get from literature as potential evidence for our argument. Therefore, before using them, we should check the validity and reliability of these results. Also, there are no perfect studies. Each study has its own limitations. We may need to evaluate the strengths and weaknesses. And finally, we need to decide the significance and relevance, how significant the study is, and how relevant it is to our research will determine how we should use them in our review. After we collect all the evidence we want, we often need to further analyze them by comparing and contrasting. By comparing, we focus on looking for similarities. We may be able to identify patterns, rules, or trends in studies. We may use inductive reasoning here. By contrasting, we focus on looking for differences. We may be able to identify the essence of a subject or the factors that make the difference. We may use deductive reasoning here. Also, by putting different studies together, we may be able to identify research gaps or generate more insights through abductive reasoning. A lot of thinking and reasoning can be done here. Another quote I want to use is from a Chinese scholar who lived about 1,000 years ago. He said, "There's a two ways of studying. The first way is I explain the six classics. The second way is I use the six classics as my footnote. In Chinese, 我注六经，六经注我。The six classics are the existing knowledge widely accepted by the community at that time. In the first way of study, we try hard to develop better understanding of the existing knowledge, but we are still just a consumer of the existing knowledge. In the second way, we start to use the existing knowledge to present our own opinion. We become a producer of new knowledge. Research is about producing new knowledge, which is a more advanced way of studying. This quote actually defined the principle of literature review. Literature review is not just a summary of other people's opinion. It's not a summary of the existing knowledge. It is actually a mechanism we use to connect the existing knowledge to the current problem we have, and then further connect to our specific solution, which is a new knowledge. Your target reader usually are more interested in the current problem you try to solve, rather than the existing knowledge itself. In your review, you need to engage your reader's interest by guiding the discussion of the existing knowledge to the current problem. Usually, you should move from general to specific. And then, you need to further direct the interest from a broad problem to the specific solution you proposed, again from general to specific. And that is the logic and the effective structure of literature review. After you have done your research, you may want to put the new knowledge you produced into the pool of the existing knowledge, and that is a reverse process, as it will move from specific back to general. But that is the task of the discussion or conclusion section of your paper. Thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Liu with research tips for the underdogs. In the next video, I will explain the circles of the review process and what I mean by reading from thick to thin and then from thin to thick. Until next time, keep studying for a better life.